Hi everybody and welcome to my channel. I'm Shannon. This is a channel about my hobbies and the things I like to do. One of the things I like to do is I love to sew. I don't sew a lot for myself because I haven't mastered fitting myself, but I've sewn for years and I love to sew for other people. Right now I'm in the middle of a project, the very beginning of a project, to do costumes for a local play. This is my third year of doing costumes for this play, our production company. And my daughter actually happens to be one of the leads of the play. And so I am making a mannequin of her to use to help me make costumes. I've done it for 2 years without mannequins, and I decided this year I would really like mannequins. We bought one that will work for about half the cast of all the really small girls, but my daughter is of the bigger size. And so I'm gonna make a mannequin for her so I can make her costumes. We started off by wrapping her in saran wrap. Now, we didn't videotape this part because she didn't want me to. She didn't want me to show everybody wrapping her in saran wrap, even though she did have clothes on underneath. She still was like, no, I don't want you to show that. So we didn't film it. I do have a picture of it. If she lets me, I'll sneak it in here. But this is basically her body in saran wrap. I'm going to cut it up into pattern pieces and make it sort of like what you would get if you ordered a bootstrap pattern. I decided I wanted to do it more myself instead of ordering the bootstrap because I felt I could get a better bust and hip area doing it this way. I spent a lot of time on the internet researching and deciding which way to go, and I chose this way. So let's go start making pattern pieces. So to start off, if you look at my cellophane, I have marked her bust area, under bust, waist, upper hip, low hip, and lower hip. And we're just going to cut the pieces apart as if we were going to make a pattern. Your basic pattern pieces, I am going to get out my pattern making book, so I make sure I make everything close to the same as what I want. I want to keep shoulder caps and I want it to be as long as this. I do really want the long body. So let's pull out the pattern book and let's get going. Okay, so we need to get these to be flat. Okay, I was going to try to do this one big piece, but my daughter has a skinnier waist and bigger hips. So I think I'm going to go ahead and cut this at the waist. The back, there's a dart here. And a dart here. To make it lay much flatter. Maybe we don't need the dots. flat. Doesn't look flat at all. So there should be two darts in this. And get rid of all this extra cellophane. Didn't mark. Right or left on these. It's been so long since I've made pattern pieces. I'm like, I hope this works out right. And I'm wondering if I have to make each one, or if I can just make one. And just get rid of doing one. I'll do this one for the back. We're just going to work with the one side, and we're going to work with the right side of everything. So, and we're just going to double it, because I think she's pretty consistent on being the same on both sides. Wanted to leave plenty of room to mark my seam allowance. And I marked it over too much. Okay, so we're gonna put that there. There, there, there. Thank you. waist, armhole. Just a couple spots on the armhole. Corners. Corners. The dart. And the neck. Okay. So here are all the pieces for the mannequin. So we got the skirt front, the skirt back, the bodice back. Here's all the pieces for the bodice front. Then I have the neck and the sleeve. Okay, I'm going to start working on actually cutting out the pieces. So I'm going to start by ironing my material and getting all the wrinkles out. So here we have the top pieces all laid out, ready to cut. I'm going to trace them and then cut them out. This is the top. So I have the neck, the three pieces for the front and the bust piece, the back, the sleeve cap, and then I have plenty of fabric in case I mess up and have to redo something. I bought 4 yards of poly cotton fabric in pink, which is my daughter's favorite color. So I'm going to trace these out and then cut around them and give them a seam allowance. So I'm just going to trace everything with my pencil, tracing pencil. This is one that'll erase. So I'm basically drawing out the sewing lines, the stitch lines, and then I'll come around and mark a seam allowance on them with another color. Other than I'm cutting two pieces at once, I'll have to go back and trace the second pieces. Hi everybody, so today's the next day and I'm gonna go ahead and I have all my pieces cut out and marked. I'm gonna go ahead and start assembling it, and we have a snow day today, so my daughter happens to be home from school today, so I'm gonna try it on her and let's hope it fits and it's the right size. If not, we're gonna have to do some adjusting. So here we go. Okay, first off, we're gonna put the two fronts together. I like to batch sew, so I'll pin a bunch of stuff together that needs to go together, and then I'll move over to my sewing machine. I'll probably have to switch color in my sewing machine. Okay, I'm gonna pin a bunch of stuff together and I'll be right back. So here I have a bunch of darts marked and my front pieces marked together. And we're gonna get sewing. And I'm gonna see if I can put you, this is my first time trying to film sewing, so I'm gonna see if I can put you somewhere where you can see. When sewing darts, it's a nice little trick to bring your thread over and then follow that thread for your dart. Thank you.
So I'm gonna start off with we have some back and some front pieces, and I'm gonna pin them together at the side seams. So center. So a thing to remember is you always want to sew from the top to the bottom. So then if you make sure you pin on the right side, your pins will be going the right direction. I hate it when I get to my sewing machine, my pins are going the wrong direction. The center fronts together, which would be these. Okay. Now we can sew. That's supposed to go together. I can't remember how this should go together. No. It's that way. So I have it here. Let me mark something that I just realized I need to mark. Where's my marking pencil? There it is. And good reason not to throw your pieces away, so you can remember how to put things together. Bottoms go this way, This is the center. Okay. Okay, now let's see if I can manage to fiddle this in.